Welcome to Best of Reddit. Be sure to subscribe as we upload new content daily. Years ago, I saw an ad for a paid internship in a hotel abroad. I was pretty sure the laws protecting the employees in that country were not the best, but figured that the agency advertising the internship would help me if needed, so I applied. A few weeks later, I got accepted to a nice little hotel and I bought my tickets. At first, everything was fine. Not perfect, there were a few hiccups, but nothing the hotel manager couldn't explain away. He was quite the flirt, but I thought nothing of it, as I am a lesbian. I was older than the other interns, which already put up a bit of a barrier between us, but we got along fine both at work and during our free time. We all worked at the hotel bar. Boy oh boy, did things take a turn a few weeks later. The hotel had two bars, one by the pool and one by the restaurant. For the first few weeks, we only kept the pool bar open because there were no guests in the rooms near the bar and the noise didn't bother anyone. As the hotel filled up, the manager told us that at 6 p.m., we had to shut down the pool bar and switch to the restaurant bar. Okay, no problem. Except, the other bars had no storage place or locks or a dishwasher, so we couldn't keep anything there, which meant we had to move everything from one bar to another every night. This would have been okay, I guess, but we were not allowed to stop serving while we moved. We were exhausted by the time we were done and then had to go on working for another 5 to 6 hours. We made the mistake to once tell him that this system was not working and he forced us to stay at the hotel after hours, we are talking around midnight, just so he could yell at us to never disrespect his management style again, and if he heard another complaint, we'd be sent home with a bad performance review. I wasn't afraid of being sent home with a bad review. I was a straighter favorite student. My teachers would not have believed him, but I had bought a two-way ticket and did not have money for a new one-way ticket home, so I kept my mouth shut from then on. The boss really scared me with his changed attitude, so I doubled my work effort just to keep him from yelling at me again. Despite his explosion, he kept flirting with all the girl employees, including me. I decided to shut that down by confessing I was a lesbian. That actually worked for my benefit because he was very jealous of the other two girls and the attention they were giving the younger male employees and took it out on them in various ways while I was left alone. He also suddenly started to talk me up in front of other employees, and that resulted in him excluding me from all after-work activities, as they all hated him and thought we were buddies. He knew this and obviously thought it would make me more dependent on him. The only real friend I had was my roommate, but she was a local and not an intern, so they were allowed to make her work every single day without a day off in the entire summer. Once during the summer, quite many of the employees started to have stomach issues. I didn't, so we assumed it had something to do with coffee since I was literally the only one who didn't drink it. They went to the doctor who, when he heard where they worked, said it was the tap water and to stop drinking it. Needless to say, we started bringing water bottles to work. When the manager saw this, he told us we can't do that because the customers will get suspicious. We told him we could come with some explanation, but nope, he didn't budge. We started hiding the bottles in the restroom. Also, the manager's mom, the owner, started to accuse us of stealing alcohol because we ran out so quickly. We started keeping tabs on how many free drinks she and the manager offered their friends, family, and best customers. When we presented this sheet after a week, it was ripped apart in front of us, and from then on, we were not allowed to bring bags to the bar but had to keep them at the reception. The bar was also very badly managed, and we routinely ran out of necessary things and then had to tell customers, "Sorry, no beer, no soda, just juice," for days, which was embarrassing and sometimes scary because obviously, we were the ones who got yelled at. It was an all-inclusive hotel, so yeah, of course, they were mad, but there was nothing we could do. I am also pretty sure that I was in danger of getting an electric shock that entire summer, as there was no sufficient protection between the sink and the electrical wires of the fridge. I really and truly started to hate my boss when he once, stone cold sober, told me I was selfish to want children because children need a mom and dad, and that if I had sex with a good southern man, him, I assume, I'd be turned back to a straight girl. I had a lousy summer and I was sometimes so afraid to go to work that I couldn't sleep and actually was pretty badly sleep deprived sometimes, which resulted in near injuries. Anyways, my revenge. As I said, I booked a two-way ticket based on the day that school would start, which was when I had to be home. We all gave this information first to the agency and then to our manager himself, so I assumed everything was cool and taken care of. A few weeks before my flight home, the manager started to talk about the huge wedding the hotel would host on the day after I left. He wasn't assigning any tasks to anyone yet, but it was obvious he thought I'd be there. I just smiled and told him I was sure it would be great. He had apparently forgotten what my last day was. I arranged my own ride to the airport without telling him and just kept on working like normal. The Monday before the wedding, which was on Saturday, my boss started handing out assignment sheets. When he gave me mine, I just looked confused and said, "I'm leaving on Friday." The boss freaked out, started yelling and telling me off, and calling me a bad employee, and so on and so on. I told him, "You have my flight info. I gave it to you when we came here. I assumed you knew when I was leaving." His mother was there, too, and she was not happy with him. I had a pretty big role during the wedding, so they were screwed, as it would be really hard to find someone to just work for the one night, but it was clear that the remaining employees would not be able to handle it without any help. I worked until Thursday evening, had a pretty good going away party with the one friend I had, and left for the airport with a hangover the next morning. I also got some satisfaction from the fact that both the agency and the hotel got banned by my school and they sent out warnings to other schools as well. Because yes, I issued two complaints to the agency and never even got a reply. At least while I studied there, my school did not send any interns through that agency again and stopped advertising them. The agency still had the audacity to send me an email a year later asking if I wanted another fantastic summer. I sent him a rude, childish reply.